Hi everyone, I am Hung. In this video, I will talk about the second law of thermodynamics. So the contents of second law is this one. The first one, let me quickly give you the definition. The reversible process and irreversible process. So what is the reversible process? That means you go from A to B by one way. So when you go back from B to A, you have to follow the same way. You don't change any value, any quantity. So that process we call reversible process. Next, irreversible process. That means that you go from A to B by this way. But when you go back because of some reason, for example, the traffic jam or whatever, and you go by another way, you don't follow the previous way anymore, even though you also reach to the point A, but you go by another way. So that process we call irreversible process. Next, quasi-static and quick process. So what does it mean, quasi-static? Here, quasi-static, what does it mean? When you want to perform a reversible process, you have to apply the quasi-static. That means you have to perform very slowly. In thermodynamics, you have three important quantities. Are volume, pressure, and temperature. When you perform process from 1 to 2, and then you go back 2 to 1, so you have to go very, very slowly to keep the volume, pressure, and temperature the same like when you go from 1 to 2. Okay, but when you want to perform a reversible process, so you can perform a quick process. You move, you jump, whatever, to from 2 to 1, you don't care about the P, V, or T. Okay. Next, the Carnot theorem. What does it mean? It means that if you want to calculate the efficiency of the engine, the heat engine, for example, so you can apply the formula of Carnot cycle, of Carnot engine, and the efficiency of Carnot engine is the maximum. The other cycle also can be a heat engine, but the efficiency is always smaller than the Carnot cycle. Next, the closest integration. So when you have a reversible process, you can consider, you can divide that reversible process in many small closed circle, and each of them you can consider as a Carnot cycle, and then you calculate the integration. So we call this one is closest integration. Next, entropy. What is that? Entropy represents for the chaos of the system. We also call it color entropy, is represent for the change of the state in the system. You have many states, and entropy represent for the change of the state in the system. Next, always keep in mind the entropy of a reversible process is zero, and of other process is always bigger than like that. The entropy of process is a constant or increase. So you never have any process which entropy smaller than zero. Okay. So when you have the formula for entropy, you can calculate the change in entropy of an ideal gas. Okay, I introduce a bit about the outline of second law. Now we move to each of them, okay? Reversible and irreversible processes. From 1, you go to 2, and from 2, you back to 1 at the same way. So we call this one is reversible. To perform it, you have to use a quasi-static process. Perform it very slowly. Now we move to irreversible process. That means you go from 1 to 2 by this way, by this behavior. But when you go from 2 to 1, you go by another way or by another behavior. So we call this one is an irreversible process. To perform it, you use the quick or certain change of the system. So you have an irreversible process. Okay, that's all. Now, how to perform quasi-static process? For example, in this case, instead of quick process, you put whole object on the piston to press the air down to perform work. For quasi-static, you put just a piece to press the piston down. So that means you perform a quasi-static process. Next, what do we have? The Carnot's theorem. What is that? That means the efficiency of Carnot's cycle is maximum, and it calculated based on this formula. To clear about this formula, you can take a look on the video about the heat engine, heat pump, and refrigerator. Okay. Next, the Carnot engine. In the Carnot engine, you have four processes, and you combine four processes together. You have a closed cycle like this. In Carnot engine, you have two adiabatic processes from A to B and from C to D. So you have two processes. That one are adiabatics, and you have two isothermal processes from B to C and from C to D. So the system receive energy from hot reservoir and release energy to the cold reservoir, to like that. Okay, so as we know that the efficiency of the Carnot cycle is the maximum, okay, in comparison with the other cycle. So why is like that? So it's easy because in Carnot cycle we don't consider the friction, therefore the efficiency is maximum. So based on this theorem, so you can write this one is the formula for efficiency of any cycle. This formula we proved in the video about the engine, heat engine, heat pump, and refrigerator. This formula we just have in the previous formula, in the previous slide. So E here, I rewrite it by this one. E Carnot, I rewrite by this one. So from here, I neglect one and I rewrite the formula. Then I move this one. Then I move T cold down and Q hot up, so I have this formula. And I move this one to this side of the equation, so I have this new equation. So here you see the information from you get heat divided by temperature. Actually, this one is a heat hot, heat cold, T cold. Heat cold, what does it mean? That means the system release heat to the outside environment. So that means the system loses energy. So usually you have a minus here, okay? And Q hot, we write here, that means that the system receive energy from hot reservoir. So this one will be plus. The value of here is plus. Some of them equal or smaller, less than zero or equal zero, okay? In case of, okay, now we move to the reversible process of any closed cycle. So if you have a random closed cycle, reversible, so you can divide it to small like this, and each small cycle, closed cycle like this, you can consider as a Carnot cycle. And if you consider as a Carnot cycle, so you sum all of them if you consider as kind of cycle, so you can apply this formula. If you can apply this formula, so you rewrite this formula like assume. And how many closed process do you have here? You have many, so you sum all of them. So you have this formula. The same. If the formula equal zero when the process is reversible. Why? Because the heat here is you get the heat from hot reservoir minus the heat from release to the cold reservoir. So you have the change of heat here when you sum them. If you have a reversible cycle, that means you back to the initial state. So the heat, the change of the heat will be zero because you back to the initial state. So the initial heat, so the heat you receive is zero because you get the final heat minus the initial heat equals zero. So therefore, heat over T equals zero if that cycle is reversible. If the cycle is not reversible, that means you, with that energy, you cannot go back to the initial position. For example, you go from 1 to 2, now you want to go back. If you but if the system, when you go back, you have a friction, so you have to lose the energy for the friction. That means with that energy you receive from the hot reservoir, so you lose for the friction more, so you don't have enough energy to go back to the initial position. So you have to get more energy from system to go back to the initial position. Therefore, the change of heat in this situation is negative because the system has to lose the energy for the friction. So in this case, the change of heat is negative. Therefore, you have a negative, is smaller than zero for the irreversible cycle. I hope that you understand what I'm talking about. If you don't understand, you can email me.